Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our current affairs based MCQ series, in which what we do, we daily discuss your MCQs from current affairs perspective. So that in other words, we take up your current affairs of the day and we make MCQs of those current affairs and we discuss these MCQs with you. So today is 25 September, so let's start our discussion. So the first question is, consider the following statements about National Population Register. First, it is based on the Citizenship Act of 1955. Second, it includes both the demographic and biometric details of the residents. So we have to consider that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. Solution is C. So National Population Register is basically maintained based on the Citizenship Act, and it includes both demographic as well as biometric details. So it is a register of usual residents of the country. So it is being prepared at the local, that is village, subtown, sub-district, district, state and national level under provisions of Citizenship Act 1955 and your citizenship rules 2003, which are relating to registration of citizens and issue of national identity cards. So it is mandatory for every usual resident of India to register within the NPR, and basically definition is that a usual resident is defined for the purposes of NPR as a person who has resided in a local area for the past 6 months or more, or a person who intends to reside in that area for the next 6 months or more. So this NPR database is basically contain demographic as well as your biometric details. So it is a kind of, as per the provisions of NPR, a resident identity card will be issued to individuals over the age of 18. This will be a chip embedded smart card containing the demographic and biometric attributes of each individual. So the UID number will also be printed on the card. So what are the objectives? The objective of the NPR is to create a comprehensive identity database of every usual resident in the country. So the database would contain demographic as well as biometric particulars. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements relating to cyclones. First, eastern coast of India, that is east coast of India, is more vulnerable. Sorry, here there is a grammatical mistake. It must be is. So it is more vulnerable to cyclones than the western coast. For the Bay of Bengal, cyclones are accentuated by the breakaway typhoons from the northwest Pacific. Second, the Arabian Sea is hotter than the Bay of Bengal, which inhibits the formation and intensification of cyclone system in the former. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that the first statement is correct. Answer is A, that is one only. So if Arabian Sea, in fact, let me tell you that if a particular water body is hotter, then it is a kind of we can say enabling factor in the formation of cyclone. So certainly second cannot be correct. So yes, first is correct. So why eastern coast of India is more vulnerable? Basically, in addition to the storms that region in the southeast Bay of Bengal and the adjoining Andaman Sea, so there are also breakaway typhoons that also come from your North Pacific and they move across the South China Sea into the Bay of Bengal, and they then get intensified into cyclones. In contrast, the Arabian Sea cyclones are mostly their own formations and they generally move northwest away from India's west coast. So basically cyclones have the tendency to move from your east to west. So in that context, obviously east coast of India comes in the path of these cyclones that originate in the Bay of Bengal or that cross over into the Bay of Bengal from your Pacific Ocean. So besides the Arabian, besides also one more thing is that Arabian Sea is colder than the Bay of Bengal, so which inhibits the formation and intensification of cyclone system in the former. So warm sea surface temperature is an ideal platform for cyclones. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, Umeed initiative seen in news is related to. It tackles genetic disease, improves skill development, C, platform for entrepreneurship, D, none of the above. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you friends that answer is A. So Umeed initiative is basically to tackle inherited genetic diseases of newborn babies. So So friends, you might be aware of all these things that these genes play an important role in the entire your physical, biological and other traits of a particular organism. So in that context, some diseases are also inherited. So in this context, UMID initiative was is launched by the government, and it is unique methods of management and treatment of inherited disorders initiative. So please remember it, it is very important. So Department of Biotechnology has started this initiative. So it is basically designed on the concept of prevention is better than cure. So obviously if you can prevent a particular disease, then it is much better, because cure is always a kind of, we can say, if you, for example, if you prevent your car from getting we can say getting smashed from anything, then that will be a good thing, rather than letting it hit on the road or let it break and focusing upon improving its condition. So prevention is better than cure. So MCQs aims to create awareness about genetic disorders amongst clinicians and establish molecular diagnostics in hospitals so that the fruits of developments in medical genetics reach the patients in India. So this is basically MCQs initiative aims to establish NIDAN, that is National Inherited Disease Administration, Kendras to provide counseling and prenatal testing and diagnosis, management and multidisciplinary care in government hospitals wherein the influx of patients is more. So next, the focus is produce skilled clinicians in human genetics and undertake screening of pregnant women and newborn babies for inherited genetic diseases in hospitals at aspirational districts. So need is that in India's urban areas, congenital malformations and genetic disorders are the third most common cause of mortality in newborns. So in that context, with a very large population and high birth rate, it is essential that this prevalence of genetic disorders is treated. So establishment of patient care services for genetic disorders is the need of the time. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to participatory guarantee scheme. First, it is the initiative of Ministry of Agriculture to certify organic products. Second, the farmers having organic certificate will be eligible to interest subvention scheme to avail low cost loans. So which of the above statements is correct, friends? Only one statement is correct, that is first. So it is an initiative of basically your Union Agriculture Ministry. So head of India's food safety regulator has said that she expects Union Agriculture Ministry participatory guarantee scheme to incentivize more farmers to grow organic food. So participatory guarantee scheme is basically this government of India scheme that is being implemented by Union Ministry of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare. So it is a process of certifying organic products. So you can't claim your products as organic unless and until they get certification of that, that they are originally organic. So in that context, this it is a process of certifying organic products, and which ensures that their production takes place in accordance with the laid down quality standards, because obviously chemical based crops can't be called organic crops. So there must be minimum standards so that a particular crop or a particular produce can be or a particular product can be considered organic. So there is a quality there are quality standards. So seeing those quality standards, whether the these product meet those quality standards, they are certified as organic or inorganic products. So certification is in the form of a documented logo or a statement. So according to International Federation of Organic Agriculture Movements, the bone-based global umbrella organization for the organic agriculture movement, PGS, are locally focused quality insurance systems that certify producers based on active participation of stakeholders and are built on a foundation of trust, social networks and knowledge exchange. So what is the benefit? Basically, procedures are simple, documents are very basic, and farmers understand all the local language used. And all members live close to each other and are known to each other. So this is about your this question. You can read it in detail. So let's move to the next question of the day. Next is LOX methane engine is seen in news recently. Consider the following statements about it. First, the engine is designed to completely replace the imported crude oil. Second, the methane, apart from being non-toxic, has a higher specific impulse, which means 1 kg of the gas can life 1 kg of mass for a longer time. It is easy to store, does not leave a residue upon burning, less bulky, and importantly, can be synthesized up in space. So which of the above statements is correct? Let me tell you, friends, that if a statement seems to you that it is quite lengthy, then you can guess that this statement can be correct. But let me tell you that guessing is a very bad habit. It is very important that you must avoid it. So I'm just giving you the, if in case, for example, you are in a total we can say do or die situation, then you can do such guessing, but not in a particular situation when you have when you know enough answers of the questions. So don't jeopardize your paper by guessing the answers. So answer is B, that is second only. So obviously, friends, the UPSC is smarter than you people, and also we people. So they know how to, we can say, deceive or trick the students. So ISRO is developing LOX methane engines. So why use methane? Because it is synthesized with water and carbon dioxide in space. So it is often described as space fuel of the future. So it is unsymmetrical dimethyl hydrazine along with nitrogen tetroxide for oxidizer. Currently that is used by ISRO is said to be highly toxic and cancer causing. But methane is where it is non-toxic, it has a higher specific impulse, easy to store, not leave a residue upon burning, and can be synthesized up in space. Next is, consider the following statements about the Silent Valley National Park. First, it is located in Eastern Ghat. Second, it is a part of Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you, friends, that the correct statement is B, that is second only. So Nilgiri, this Silent Valley National Park is basically, it is in Palakkad district and Nilgiri Mountains of Kerala. So it is at the heart of Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve and consists of the areas of Southwestern Ghats rainforest and tropical wet evergreen jungles. So River Kunti passes through it. So flora is basically humid wet evergreen rainforest, and the major plants of the park are teak, amla, semal, rosewood along with the bamboo. So fauna is known for many highly endangered species such as lion-tailed macaw, tiger, gaur, and leopard, wild boar, panther, Indian civet, and your sambar. Next is seven. Consider the following statements related to India's intended nationally determined contribution under the UNFCCC, that is United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. First, reduce emission intensity to India's GDP by 33 to 35% by 2030 from 2005 levels. Second, achieve 40% cumulative electric power installed from non-fossil fuels. So which of the above statements is correct? Let me tell you, friends, that both of these statements are correct. Yes, we can say aimed to reduce our emission intensity by 33 to 35% so by 2030. So also it aims to achieve this cumulative electric power installed from non-fossil fuels, and the target is 44%. So basically these are India's intended nationally determined contribution. So India has also pledged to create an additional carbon sink of 2.5 to 3 billion tons of CO2. So you can create it through massive afforestation, promoting afforestation campaigns and drives. So India will anchor a global solar alliance as well, that is International Solar Alliance, and then this will ensure that energy from non-fossil fuels can be channelized. Next is, India's initiative Coalition for Disaster Resilient Infrastructure is in line with which of the following convention agreement? A, Paris Agreement, B, UNFCCC, C, Kyoto Protocol, D, Sendai Framework for Action. So friends, the answer is D, that is Sendai Framework for Action. So it is in this initiative of India, that is Coalition for Disaster Resilient Infrastructure. It is in consonance of this Sendai Framework. So it is basically, what is this Coalition for Disaster Resilient Infrastructure? It basically, each time when natural disaster occurs anywhere in the world, so countries try to provide immediate relief, but there is no focus on building disaster resilient infrastructure. So friends, as we have read earlier also in this video, video, in this video, that prevention is much better than cure. So there must also be focus upon developing such infrastructure that must be resilient and can be, we can say, can be of the level that can bear the brunt of this natural disasters. So in this context, India has proposed that this coalition for disaster resilient infrastructure, which will act as a convening body that will pool best practices and resources from around the world for reshaping construction, transportation, energy, telecommunication and water. So all these are very important things, because in natural disasters, these all these facilities are we can say are badly hit. So for example, construction, transportation, energy, telecommunication, water. So in that case, so these all these core infrastructure sectors must factor in the natural catastrophes while in their designing phase or in their developing phase. So according to Sindhi framework, every $1 spent in disaster risk reduction leads to gain of $7. So but developing countries face the dilemma of balancing economic investment for development versus disaster resilient infrastructure. So this CDRI could fill this gap of funds and technology, helping your developing countries to build disaster resilient infrastructure. So for instance, India is a world leader in preventing human deaths due to disasters. So the United Nations Office for Disaster Risk Reduction has in fact praised India for India's zero casualty approach and playing a pioneering role for global community for drawing up a national and local strategy to reduce disaster losses and risks. So this is where CDRI can help. Japan has expertise in disaster management, rehabilitation and reconstruction, making it the world's safest and most disaster resilient country. So it is very important. So because Japan is particularly prone to very high intensity earthquakes as well as tsunamis, so it has very high expertise in this entire management, rehabilitation and reconstruction. So India can also can work with Japan to develop such type of infrastructure. Next is plagiarism detection software is launched by which ministry? Ministry of HRD, Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, and Ministry of Commerce. D, none of the above. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is A. Solution is A. Basically, it is a plagiarism detection software launched by Union Ministry. So it is implemented by the Information and Library Network and Inter-University Center of UGC. So significance is basically it will help improve the quality of research outcome by ensuring the originality of ideas and publication of the research scholars. Next is consider the following statements related to Shondol dance. First, it is famous dance which was earlier used to be performed by artists for the King of Sikkim on special occasion. This dance has entered into the Guinness Book of World Records. So which of the above statements is correct? Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. Answer is C, that is both 1 and 2. So it is basically the dance has entered into this Guinness Book of Records. So it is also known as Royal Dance of Ladakh. So it is basically the famous dance that was earlier performed by the artist for the kings of the Ladakh on only special occasions. So please not remember its name, that is Shondol dance. So this is all about friends today's discussion about current affair MCQs. So if you like this video, if you like the questions, if you like the quality of the explanation, then do ensure that you at least help us by liking our video, by sharing our video with other people which can get benefit by this video. So specifically friends, why we have launched this initiative in English, because entire your UP and this North Indian belt is Hindi. And basically the South Indian students, particularly South Indian aspirants, they face the difficulty because there are already a lot of channels that are there for Hindi speaking people, but very few initiatives are there which can help the South Indians as well. So in this context, though I'm from North India, but we have decided that we will be only making our videos in English only, so that the people from all over the country can benefit from it. So I'm using English as a lingua franca, though the government of India is saying that we should promote Hindi. So that is a different thing, but if you like this discussion, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, as well as subscribe to our channel. And lastly friends, if you want to remain in touch with our updates that we do on our channel, then you can join our public Telegram channel that is shown on your screen, and the link of which will also be provided in the description box. So you can check the description box and can join our public Telegram channel to remain in touch with us. And also you can visit our website, that is www.achieveias.co.in, for various updates that we keep on doing on our website, so that you people can get the latest information about the exam. So also, if you have any queries, if you have any doubts, you are more than welcome to mail us at achieveias21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at 8968920720. So these are the details. So, and let me tell you, friends, if in case you are interested to get the PDFs of these MCQs, you can contact us on these details, or you can also check the description box where the link will be given. Obviously we have kept a minimum fee of ₹99 per month for the PDFs of these MCQs, because this piece has been solely kept for the purpose of our motivation, so that we people can remain motivated to help you people, because after all we also have to sustain ourselves. So if in case you want to get the PDFs, you are more than welcome to check the description. You can check the description box. The link is for subscription is there, or you can also contact us and can reach to us for the subscription link. So this is all about today's video. Thank you. Have a very nice day ahead.